there's real in here. So I, you know, read it first. And I've got teachers out there in Ohio and all over the country that have already done this with their kids. So this is not going to get you fired probably, but go ahead and read the book, okay, if that's interesting. Again, get the audiobook if you want to do it that way. I want to take this one more step. If we have any time at all at the end of this, I want to talk about an AI extension for maybe taking this to a whole other level.
Okay.
Yeah
we definitely have time.
Yeah, keep going. I mean, just yeah, jump right into it. Yeah.
Okay, so I'm out there in the world. At the World of Work conference in San Diego, and I'm keynoting that, and I met a guy from a company called Schooljoy, and you can start Googling right now, Schooljoy. And what do? They build this profile. They build this dossier. Every kid in your school takes a 1.5-minute survey, and it lays out, how do I get to know Eric? What, by the way, self-reported by Eric. So now suddenly I build a math lesson, and it changes my math lesson to fit every kid in my class according to their interest. It's using AI to do all of that. It's pulling a database that's already in your school information system. This is so far beyond everything else out there that we're using for school information systems because it's using AI. Now, you could turn off the AI and say, I'm scared of it. I don't want to get fired. But I would tell you, I've watched this. And if you ask for a demo from Schooljoy, you're going to see, I don't work for them. I don't get a dime from them. But if something's good, I'm going to talk about it. And this is a young entrepreneur putting his own money into this company. He hasn't even launched yet, but there's a few schools out there that are piloting this. So once the kids take that, and by the way, any new kid that comes in, boom, profile. Boom, I got information. I know about their interests. I know about their hobbies. I know about all kinds of different things that inform. Now, when you watch this and suddenly you're building a math lesson and you're watching it build a different lesson for every kid in your class, it's the kind of stuff they told us to do that we never had time to do. Individualized instruction, that'd be nice if you had the time, but you got a wife and you got kids and you got a mortgage. This does it. I've never seen anything like it. And so, yes, I'm in with both feet, and I'm telling them I want to go and be a part of any of these schools that are trying this out. And now remember, the leading edge is the bleeding edge, and we're going to learn some things. In the meantime, now you've got a tool that can individually cater to each kid and maybe help us be more attuned to the different kids that we have. And I say different, I mean the unicorns and the weirdos and the ones who don't tell you anything. What would it look like if we really knew our kids? What would that look like? So, yeah. A feeling seen. Now, by the way, let me just follow up, okay? Literally 7 days ago, I get a kid reaching out to me on Instagram. His sister reached out to me. He was in my first class as a teacher. And he says, can he call me? He's about to turn 50, guys. That's how old I am. I get him on the phone, and he says, this is Ben. Do you remember me? I said, are you kidding, buddy? I got a T-shirt with your face on it. I drew all of you. And he showed me the certificates I made for him. I did with calligraphy. There was no software. He still has all of them.
Wow.
I'm like, wow. He said, you made a connection. He said, I just want to tell you something. I got bullied relentlessly in our town. But your class was one place I could come and feel seen. Those same words. He said, the most important thing that every kid deserves is to feel seen. And I'm sitting here crying because I didn't know.
No.
I didn't know. All I know is this, that every kid needs to feel important. And they need to know why they're there. And if I get fired for doing the right thing, I'd rather get fired than keep a job not doing the right thing. I think this has the potential to help us use a new tool to do something we should have been doing the whole time, but we just didn't have time. I mean, I understand we're not superhuman, but maybe AI has the promise of helping us do something really important. So by the way, I want to get Ben's curriculum into Schooljoy and just make it a module. So if, you've read Bleak, cool. Want to try click the button. Now suddenly I can do this for my whole school.
Wow.
Yeah.
That's awesome. So, yeah. That's awesome. I appreciate sharing that. That's, I mean, not only the story, also the resources, the idea, because again, we talked a little bit about, you know, sometimes when new things come out, we want to right away just make it this evil thing that's coming to take over the world. But yet there are benefits to harness it. You have to understand it, you know, and that's kind of been Domini's stance with the AI where we talk about it, because in the end, who are the people that have to teach the kids how to do it? Like, you want it to be the parents, but a lot of times it falls on the school to do the different things. And that AI piece, bringing in that book, like, that's awesome. I already know I'm messaging my guidance counselor, and we're, you know, looking at that. And looking at his curriculum, and that's an awesome thing. So I truly appreciate you sharing that story. Really do. So,
yeah.
Let me reinforce that with a metaphor, okay?
Yeah.
30,000 plus years ago, one of your ancestors, an upper Paleolithic hunter-gatherer, invented the Clovis point. You know what the Clovis point was? A spear tip, okay. Right? Chipped okay. out of rock. It could be igneous rock. It could have been shale. It could have whatever, but it had a serrated edge. Now that could go on a spear tip, and suddenly they could hunt from a distance, right? And that was important. It was the first peripheral device, if you will, right? And I'm sure there were tribes who didn't embrace it, who said things like "Mahogazimo," because we were prelingual at the time. thanks. I'm gonna tell
you.
Yeah,
I think you nailed it. That was perfect. Yeah.
Right. Yeah.
But the tribes and the clans and the groups who didn't embrace it, their descendants aren't here. They're not among us. They didn't make it. It turns out the Clovis point mattered. So to avoid the Clovis point is to ensure the end of your line.